So, what about working private and public collections?
Oh wow. I should have brought a list with me. Right now I'm stumped, but I had worked in two Fillmore galleries, Grace Baptist Church, York College, New York University, Abyssinian. My work is in the Abyssinian Baptist Church collection. Wow. I mean,
You got a lot.
I probably have a list that can fill up two pages, and I've forgotten because it's just too numerous venues to actually remember. I write all of this stuff down.
No problem. No problem. Tell us about Dorsey. How important is Dorsey Gallery to you?
Well, that's easy. The Dorsey Art Gallery opened its doors in 1970.
Okay.
The founder of that gallery's interests were children, art, and golf, in that order. And his interest in art spread out further than most gallery owners would be, because he was a master framer, and like me, he loved to teach. So he would teach anybody that would listen, whether they were artists, whether they were collectors. You were always welcome, and this is a key word, you were always welcome at the Dorsey Art Gallery. The Dorsey Art Gallery is the oldest continuously run, black-owned and operated art gallery in the entire metropolitan area. If you think about it, at least a third of the people walking the earth today were not born when Dorsey opened those doors in 1970. So that's a over 50 years of helping young and established artists in the community and in the United States. All of the biggies have gone through the Dorsey Art Gallery. Ernie Krishlow, Ann Tainsley, James Denmark, and Jacob Lawrence, Bearden, Elizabeth Catlett, all of these great, great artists, Jonathan Green, all of these great artists have pierced those doors and had their works hung on those walls. So, as a black-owned and operated gallery, it is truly historic in nature.
Yes, I'm feeling blessed already hearing the spoken words from you, and plus your journey and your spiritual journey, the whole work. So it's a privilege. So this last question here, well, actually is I think is maybe one or two. What do you consider to be the most important in your life of art?
Oh, all right. I would have to say my abstract work. And that's based on the fact that I was taught this skill by unseen forces. And I have watched over and over and over again how people are affected by it when they see it. It, for them, it can be uplifting. At my first one-man show at the Fillmore Gallery, a young lady came in off the street. She stood in front of one of my paintings and just started to cry. And she asked, "Is the artist there?" And she came over to me and she said, "I just wanted you to know that I'm an artist, but I had stopped working. And looking at your art, it gave me the inspiration to go home, take out the paint, the brushes, and the canvases, and start to work." And in many instances, similar stories I have heard about how people react to the work. And it's my belief that every piece of abstract art that I complete is destined to help one person. And eventually, it will do that because my abilities are gifts from God. And in many ways, I believe that I'm a conduit. That there's a purpose behind the abstract art that goes far beyond me.
You're right. What we're gonna do is a couple of things. One is that your message is here. You have a powerful, powerful story and a powerful message to give to the community and the young artists of every ethnicity, towards building their own lifestyle and going to art, because there's a purpose for everybody. And you already told your purpose, the way I feel that is really coming from God, that saved you, that brought you back. And it's a reason why you are here. It's a reason why you are talking to me. Because now you're not just talking to me, you're talking to over 3 million people. So it's a reason for this, why we having this interview. And I think it's a bigger than what we think it is, but you are one of the vessels that's going to share your message to the community. So what I want to do now, before we talk a little bit about some of your artwork that is shown on this wall right here, is look in this camera right here and give a message to the community. What message would you give them as far as becoming an artist, and what you just went through? So what message would you give them?
Creating art is an act of love. And through that creative process, you gain so much on a personal level that's incredible. When I paint abstract art, I am dancing, I am singing. I hardly pay attention to what I am doing because the forces of God slash love is actually working through me. I happen to paint abstract work flat. And it's really incredible. The only thing that I do when it comes to abstract work that I can claim to be my own is I picked out the medium. I pick out the paper and what size. I pick out the canvas and what size. But everything else, my choice of colors, the design within the artwork is something that works through me. I be enjoying the process, loving it. I be singing, I be dancing. I'm spiritually uplifted and happy. And I know when to stop. And I know when the piece is complete. It's when the name of the piece pops in my head, I've learned to stop right there. And that's the first time that I really look at the word and see what was created through me.
You have an extraordinary story. Extraordinary. You got 24 artwork pieces, right? So if you got within 10 minutes to talk about or real short, about your artwork that is being displayed, you can sum it all up, in a way where people would understand it.
Well, let me put it to you this way. All my life, I have always wanted to be in a position to help others and assist others where I can, teach others. And with the artwork that I am creating now, it gives me a much, much more dramatic tool to also allow people to see what I see and feel what I feel, because the artwork represents glimpses into the world that I actually live in. So when you see my art, you see little tiny snippets of who I am on the inside. And that gives me an opportunity to share me with everyone that sees my art.
Well said. You definitely shared it with me, the world, with everything else, with everybody. And it's been a privilege. It's been an honor to have you on my show. I am very pleased. Thank you very much.
Well, I am very honored to be here.
Yes.
And you're a good host, because normally, no, not normally, I'm a very nervous type person. I like to stay in the background and help from behind. In any organization that I am, I like the glue.
Yes.
Wherever something is needed, that's where I step in. But I always have a sort of nervous reaction to public speaking. Although I know personally, and people have told me, that I do it very well, but still inside, I'd rather not.
Yes.
And but I learned a little trick. And that trick is, I don't prepare notes for public speaking. Not that I don't have an outline in my mind, but just before I walked through that door, I said, "Father, from your mind to my lips."
There you go.
And that chills me.
Yes, it did. Yes, it did. Yeah, I felt that too from you. You know, it's a spiritual connection here, you know. And I think that's what made you really calm and collected. And it's coming from the heart. And once you feel that, the environment that you are in, or the person, the host, like myself, that is speaking with you, it lets you know that we okay. We all on the same wavelength, so we good, you know. And I think that's what makes you tell your story even much better. So I want to thank you again. It was a pleasure, an honor to have you as my guest. Thank you very much.
And I want to thank you for this opportunity.
Yes.
And to share me with everyone that this piece reaches. And today, share part of me with you.
There you go.
Thank you.
Well, God is watching.
Oh, yeah.
He's there. Thank you.
You got to find out what your ability is. And don't be shy about it. You know what I mean? Because I know a lot of artists, when they first start out, they're shy. And, oh, I don't think I'm an artist. Well, maybe in the beginning you're not an artist. But practice make perfect.
Yes, indeed.
A cat learn how to play music, he just don't play it right away. I mean, it's something he got to work on. And he work, usually when you work with somebody else that does the same thing you do, that have more skill than you, mm-hmm. they teach you. Because I've learned so much from being around artists. And most time, artists will teach you or tell you anything that they know that goes with the craft. It's very few times you might find somebody that don't want to share with you what they know when it comes to artistic ability. Like I say, writing, dancing, playing music, visual art, poetry. Most of these people are glad to share what they know with you.
Mm-hmm.
So explore yourself, explore your ability. And if you're shy, it's okay, but that don't mean you can't do it. Because if you don't do it, it's not done. That piece is called Mr. America. And this piece was done, that's found art. That's a piece that was in the Brooklyn Museum show, the found art.
Okay.
And this is a piece I just did recently. But I'm just saying to the youth, try to stay out of trouble. Don't hang around people that trouble is what they do. Because they're bored or they don't want to do something that's constructive. They'd rather do something that's destructive. Unless the negative things come to you and touch you, that you got to deal with it in a positive way. You got to get rid of the negativity and use positive energy to get rid of the negativity. That's what you got to do. You got to do the right thing. That's what you have to do. Because nobody can do the right thing for you but you. And usually when there's something negative, it's a lesson for you to learn and not do that again. So anything that happens is a lesson for you to learn. So you can beat negativity with positiveness, with harmony. And if you need to talk to somebody, find somebody to talk to that you think is positive, that might understand you or be able to explain to you the difference between what you need to do and do it. Because things don't change themselves. People don't change themselves without changing themselves. You can't say, I'm going to do it, I'm going to change, and don't change yourself. You can't stop a bad habit unless you stop a bad habit. Because a habit don't stop itself. You have to stop yourself. You can go all the rehab you want to. You can go to rehab for the rest of your life. But if you don't stop what the negativeness that you're doing, it don't stop for you. So try to be positive. Try to balance your life. Try to stay in the harmony. And like I say, if you need help, find somebody to talk to that can help you. Because today, let me say this. When I was growing up, there were people that were hooked on certain things. And they were hooked on it because people used to bring it to our neighborhood to hook us. Well, now they got this thing going on where people are hooked on painkillers, this, that, blah, blah, blah. So now it's a big thing that they want to save everybody. And that's not a bad thing. And having a bad habit is a bad thing. Because I know how those people feel that are hooked on this, hooked on that. It's not easy to give up. But the only way you can give it up is to start by giving it up. Saying, I ain't going to do this no more. Because usually when you're hooked on something, you think that if you stop it, you're going to die. No, you might feel bad for a couple of days. But you're not going to die. Because when you're hooked on something, it's your body telling you you need it. Your mind is telling you you don't need it, but your body is saying you do need it, right? Like people that like to eat cake, blah, blah, blah. Your body's saying, I need some sugar. I need some sugar. Eat some cake. And your mind is saying, you know that cake ain't good for you. Got too much sugar in it. But your body is saying you need it, like soda. Hey, your body's saying, I need a soda. And your mind is saying, you know soda ain't good for you. So it becomes a struggle between the negative and the positive.
A great story.
But if you know it's negative and you continue to do it, it's not positive. It's negative. But you know that if you stop doing it, you ain't going to die. You going to get better. Because some of the habits I used to have, I used to say, because my body used to tell me you need it. And you don't need it because your mind is telling you don't do it. But it becomes a struggle between your body and your mind. And sometimes the body went out. But it's your mind that rules your body. Mm-hmm. It's not your body that rules your mind. So people need to get their mind together and start using their mind to run their life and not let your body run your life. Great. Your brain is the functioning organ in your head that tells you, don't do it. Listen to your brain, not to your body. Even though your body sometimes tells you something is wrong, like a pain. A pain is a message. And if you get a pain that you can't figure it out, go see the doctor. You know what I mean? But use your mind. Your mind is what controls your body. Your body don't control you. So don't let your body control you. Let your mind control you. Because that's what it's for.
So, Mr. Carr, that was a good message, powerful message to give to the young people.
I didn't know how to stop.
Don't worry about it. That's like you said, this is you. This is your time.
Hey.
But if someone's seeing your art that you're showing up here and they wanted to contact you to purchase your art, how would they do that?
I got the a number here. Can I give you that information right now?
Yeah, you can give you can talk to them right there and give the information right there to them.
Well, I'll talk to you because they're going to hear me talking to you.
Yeah. However you want to do it.
The number is, listen to this, write it down, OMOYELE, Omoyele, period, MCINTOSH at gmail.com. You send any messages to me, KMI, to that, what do you call it?
What is that?
Email address or what is that?
Yeah, you either got the a Gmail.
Or Gmail, yeah.
I don't know if yours is a Gmail or Yahoo.
Well, that's what it is. Okay. What do you call that?
Gmail. Gmail.com.
That's what you call email?
Well, it depends. Which email are you referring to?
No. What do you call that? A call? What's that message?
It is an email.
It's an email. Well, yeah. Send it to
email, and then you give your address, email address.
OMOYELE. That's Omoyele, period, MCINTOSH at gmail.com.
There you go.
And I'll get that message. Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. Melvin.
And thank you for coming on my show.
Thank you very much.
You was a very powerful speaker. I'm pretty sure you inspired a lot of people out there. And with your story and your message, and I'm very, very happy that you are here or that you did an interview with me. So hopefully we can continue on doing more interviews.
I'll be back tomorrow.
Hey.
What time?
Same time, same station. Hey. Yeah, so this is very good because what we've been doing, I tell the audience that we started off with the, I created a platform for the artists at the Dorsey Art Gallery. And so far we have, we start off with Art O'Neill, and then we started off with, after that it was Joe, and now it's Karl. And we also interviewed Diane, and we're going to interview a few other people there as well. And we're starting off that way, so we're going to give respect to the ones that was before us, because Dorsey has a great history, and Karl is one of them. And so now we have Karl. Well, it took us a little while, but we finally got him, and now y'all see his work. And his work is is extraordinary. It's fabulous. It's beautiful. It's something that, you know, that it can inspire anyone. So again, thank you again for coming on my show.
Well, Melvin, I have
to tell you, it's a pleasure.
I'm thanking you a lot because obviously it gave me a chance to say what I think I needed to say to people out there.
Yes, 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 it did.
And it needed to be said. I feel better that I said it.
Yes.
Because maybe I never said it that way before, but I'm thanking you very much for giving me the opportunity to say what I think people need to hear because I heard it too.
There you go.
And I needed that.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.